Test 7, Part 3. Scene, Test 7. We are looking for the correct order of acidic strength. As we know, acidic strength is proportional to stability of conjugate base. Stability of conjugate base after removal of H+. In case of trifluoroacetic acid, 3 fluorine atoms are attached to carbon atom. And in trichloroacetic acid, 3 chlorine atoms are attached with carboxylic group. And acetic acid, CH3 group. And here formic acid, HCOH. As we can see that 4 acids are given, formic acid, acetic acid, trifluoroacetic acid and trichloroacetic acid. As we can see that fluorine is most electron withdrawing group, so it makes the OH bond weaker. Chlorine is also withdrawing group, but power of fluorine is more than chlorine. So acidic strength of trifluoroacetic acid is more than trichloroacetic acid. So we can see that in option A, the compound A given is trichloroacetic acid. Chloroacetic acid, and B option is trifluoroacetic acid. So B is more acidic than A. Out of formic acid, we can see CH3's electron releasing group makes OH bond stronger. H can neither release or neither withdraw electron. So OH bond will remain as it is. So CF3 will make OH bond highest weaker. So most acidic is trifluoroacetic acid, then trichloro, after that formic acid. Formic acid is D, and then acetic acid. So question number 31, option A is correct. See question number 32. In question number 32, we are looking for correct order of reactivity towards electrophilic substitution. As we know, electrophilic substitution reaction depends on electron releasing group nature. Electron releasing group will increase electrophilic substitution reaction, and electron withdrawing groups will decrease electrophilic substitution reaction. As we can see that 3 compounds are given. One is aniline. As aniline contains NH2, which is plus M group, electron releasing group, it will increase the electrophilic substitution reaction. Then benzene has no group over it, while NO2 is electron withdrawing group. It withdraws electron density from ring. NH2 increases electron density, therefore makes electrophilic substitution easier, while NO2 withdraws electron from the ring, makes electrophilic substitution difficult. So 1, 2 and 3 order of electrophilic substitution is correct. So question number 32, option B is correct. See question number 33. In question number 33, we can see that 4 compounds are given. These are the 4 compounds. As we can see that after which question is order of reactivity of CX bond. As we can see that after removal of CX bond, it is 3 degree carbocation, which is more stable. And after removal of CX bond, it is 2 degree carbocation, which is more stable. And we can know that reactivity of aliphatic CX bond. So first 2 have less reactivity than last 2. And out of these 2, 3 degree carbocation is more stable after breaking of CX bond. So highest reactivity for this compound. And after second degree will be less reactive than 3 degree. So we can say that the compound containing NO2 group will withdraw electron from the ring, makes the CX bond weaker. While in this case CX bond is stronger, so reactivity is less, as there is partial double bond character. As there is partial double bond character, therefore CX bond is strongest in case of this, while CX bond is weaker than this because NO2 is an electron withdrawing group. While in these two, as 3 degree carbocation is more stable than 2 degree, therefore CX reactivity is maximum in this case. CX reactivity is maximum in this case. So we can say that third is more reactive than fourth, and then 2, and then 1. So question number 33, option A is correct. See question number 34. In question number 34, what is given? Question number 34, the question is about which one is most reactive towards nucleophilic addition reaction. Nucleophilic addition reaction, as we know, nucleophilic addition reaction is directly proportional to minus M and minus I groups. Minus M and minus I group increases the nucleophilic addition reaction rate. As in option D, we can see that nucleophilic addition reaction at carbonyl carbon, and the group present is NO2, and NO2 at meta position show minus M effect. NO2 at para position will show minus M effect. Therefore, minus M increases the rate of nucleophilic addition reaction. So question number 34, option D is correct. See question number 35. In question number 35, what is given there? Which of the following is most correct electron displacement representation? As we can see that in option D, CH3CH double bond CH2Cl as per option D. As Cl is minus I group, it will withdraw electron from the main chain. This pi electron will shift to that position. When this pi electron will shift that position, carbon forms pi bond, which is less stable, as carbon can form maximum of 4 bonds. So chlorine will act as a leaving group. Chlorine will remove. Also, it is minus I group. And CH3 is an electron releasing group, that is plus I. So this is the correct representation of electron traveling. So question number 35, option D is correct. As CH3 plus I release and Cl withdraw minus I, and this pi bond shift at this position, then carbon form pi bonds, which is unstable. Therefore, Cl must be removed from that position. Now question number 36. In question number 36, the reaction is given there. Compound is CH3, C double bond O, H, and addition of HCN gives CH3, C, H, CN, OH. The first is addition takes place at the carbonyl carbon. This is correct because CN minus attacks at carbonyl carbon. So first option is correct. And addition is regioselective. This is also correct. As addition of CN is possible at this carbon atom, so it is region selective. Therefore, we can say it is regioselective. As we can see that when product is formed, there are 4 different groups are attached. So it is chiral carbon. Chiral carbon produce and resting mixture. When chiral carbon, then resting mixture is produced. So option B is also correct. As we can see that geometry, first it is sp2 hybridized, and after forming product, it is sp3. So question number 36, option C is also correct. Geometry of reactant is trigonal planar, while the product is tetrahedral. So all the above statements are true. So question number 36, option D is correct. See question number 37. In question number 37, which of the following alkyl halide will be most likely to give a rearranged product? We are looking for rearranged product. product of alkyl halide. As we can see that the compound given in option C, bromine, when bromine removes it forms carbocation. It forms carbocation that is 1 degree. It forms carbocation that is 1 degree carbocation. From there we can see 1,2 methyl shift will takes place. On shifting of 1,2 methyl shift, then this carbon contains positive charge and this position contains now 2 methyl groups. Now it becomes from 1 degree carbocation to 3 degree carbocation, which is more stable. So option number C will give a rearranged product. Most likely rearranged product is given by option C. So question number 87, option C is correct. As stability increases, therefore rearrangement is possible. See question number 38. In question number 38, which is given, increasing order of electrophilic substitution. As we know, electrophilic substitution reaction is directly proportional to the groups attached on benzene ring are plus M plus H, and inversely proportional to minus M and minus H. So as we see, in first toluene CH3 group is attached and CH3 acts as a plus H group, so electron density will increase, electron releasing group. But benzene there is no such group, so electrophilic substitution is faster in toluene than benzene, and the group attached on benzene ring in third is COH. This is minus M group. Minus M group decreases the electrophilic substitution rate. Therefore, most reactive for electrophilic substitution is 1, and then 2, and then 3. So, question number 38, option B is correct. See, question number 39. In question number 39, what is given? Which one of the following is the most reactive towards electrophilic substitution reaction? As we can know, the order of activating groups for electrophilic substitution reaction are: most activating group is NH2, and then OH, and then NHCOCH3, and then OCOCH3, and after that alkoxy, and then methyl. This is the correct order of activating group, orthopara directing order, or activating groups. As we can see that CH3 is fixed, so OH will increase the most electron density on the ring. So best reagent towards electrophilic substitution when OH group is attached. So question number 39, option A is correct. See question number 40. In question number 40, the compound given and product is also given. CH3, CH double bond, CH, and CH3 plus HBr. Product is also given. As we can see that in product, the addition takes place at this position, CH2, while remaining as it is, CH3. As we can see that in case of buta-1,3-diene, when addition is 1,2 addition, then first and second position will get bromine and hydrogen. This is 1,2 addition. Similar in case of this, we can compare this with buta-1,3-diene. This is 1,2,3,4. As bromine is attached to this position and hydrogen attached to this position, so here we can see that bromine attached to first and hydrogen to second, while rest remain as it is. Therefore, this addition is 1,2 addition. So product is according to 1,2 addition. So question number 40, option B is correct. This is 1,2 addition. See question number 41. In question number 41, what is given? In question number 41, what is given out there? Question number 41 is dehydrohalogenation. Dehydrohalogenation means removal of hydrogen and halogen. Of an alkyl halide. As we know, this is removal means elimination reaction. So dehydrogenation is basically a elimination reaction. Question number 41, option B is correct. See question number 42. In question number 42, impure naphthalene is purified by. As we know, naphthalene is sublimating organic compound. As this is sublimating organic compound, so can be separated from non-volatile impurities. By sublimation method. So question number 42, option D is correct. So question number 41 is B correct, and question number 42, sublimation, option D is correct. See question number 43. In question number 43, what is given? Fractional distillation is used in the distillation of. As we know, in oil refineries, which distillation is used? Fractional distillation is used on the basis of Different hydrocarbons have different boiling points. Therefore, in refineries, the products are separated on the basis of fractional distillation. All the products, petroleum, coal tar, crude oil, all of these are separated by fractional distillation method. So question number 43, option D is correct. See question number 44. Question number 44 is impure glycerin can be purified by. As we know, vacuum distillation is used to purify liquids. Vacuum distillation is used to purify liquids having high boiling points. So vacuum distillation is used to purify liquids having high boiling points and those which decompose at or below their boiling point, or those which decompose at or below their boiling point, So in this method, By creation of vacuum, pressure is decreased. So vacuum pump is used to reduce the pressure. So impure glycerin can be purified by vacuum distillation method. So question number 44, option C is correct. See question number 45. Question number 45 is the sodium extract of organic compound. As we know, organic compound containing sulfur. When react with sodium, gives sodium sulfide. So sodium sulfide is formed when sulfur is present in the organic compound on reaction with sodium. It reacts with lead acetate and forms lead sulfide of black precipitate. Lead sulfide of black PPT plus sodium salt of carboxylic acid. So question number 45 is sodium extract of organic compound on acidification gives acetic with acetic acid and addition of lead acetate. Lead acetate gives a black PPT, and black PPT of which compound is lead sulfide. The organic compound contains must be sulfur. सो क्वेश्चन नंबर 45 ऑप्शन सी इज करेक्ट, इट मस्ट कंटेन सल्फर।